Oh, what do we got here? So turn one Ghost Quarter, because this hand's actually very good against combo just because it's got Mindbreak Trap and a Quick Thorn, except that it can't cast anything. Hmm. If I draw a Mox or a Mishra's Workshop, obviously keeping a hand where you need to draw Mishra's Workshop's not great, but if I draw a Mox, this hand becomes very good too. Or even a Chalice, anything that can make Tolarian Academy produce mana. So if I draw any artifact, let me take a look at how many of those cards I have in my deck. Alright, so I've got this whole stack here, so that's 6, 10, Soaring also works, 11, plus 17 lands, so it's 28. Hmm, so I have 28 cards that make that hand good. Oh, wait, no, sorry, because I already have Tolarian Academy and then the Ghost Quarter, so 27 cards that make that hand good. Alright, my opponent's still deciding whether to mulligan. If I knew for sure that my opponent was on combo, I think this would be pretty decent to keep. Because 27 cards out of 53, you know what, I'm going to keep this hand. Maybe it's horrendous, but against a turn one kill, like having a Witchblade Orb, yeah, I'm already glad I kept this. If my opponent's playing a Lotus and has City of Brass in their deck, I think Mindbreak Trap's going to be great here. Alright, ooh, my opponent is getting Duress out of here. Alright, I'm going to go down to one card in hand. Alright, this is sweet. I'm actually going to get my opponent pretty good here. Burning Wish. Sure, you can Burning Wish. Because Mindbreak Trap gets like tendrils and whatnot, I'm not too worried about that. My opponent got Yawgmoth's Will. Alright, well that, I'm pretty sure I just counter. Well, actually I don't. The reason I don't is because my opponent's last card has to be something good. So I'm going to go ahead and Mindbreak Trap whatever the last card is. Hopefully it involves my opponent sacrificing Lotus here. Oh, my opponent's got lots of mana. Do they have enough storm count? I don't actually know. Let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4 off Lotus, 5, 6 off Ritual, 7, 8, Burning Wish, okay. Alright, so now my opponent have exactly 10. They'd get to 9. And there's the Tendrils of Agony, and pretty sweet little turn 1 kill, but bam, it is a trap. Alright, let's go ahead and let the storm trigger resolve. It feels pretty filthy getting to do this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Boom. And it was, in fact, a trap. you've got to figure that Stax, you know, on the draw, is my opponent saying GG's, but I don't know. If my opponent concedes, that's fine. I wasn't actually going to win. Let's see. Basically, when you play combo against Stax, you figure, at least the games when I'm on the play and have a turn one kill, I just win. Well, mine broke that right out. So let's see. I would have drawn Lodestone Golem. So let's say my opponent hadn't conceded. They would have said go with just a black and a white Mox in play, which is not much, honestly. I'd play Ghost Quarter and say go after drawing Lodestone Golem. Next turn, I'd draw Chalice. All right, because then I'd play Chalice for zero, play Tolarian Academy, and cast Thorn of Amethyst. Presumably my opponent still can't really do a whole lot there. Then I draw, but then I tap Academy now for 2 mana because Thorn plus Chalice plus Ghost Quarter equals Metalworker, and then the turn after that, assuming my opponent hadn't done anything else, yeah, then I get to go off. I get to reveal 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 cards, so 10 mana. Definitely playing Lodestone Golem. Probably just playing like Lodestone Golem, Karn, or I guess I can pay 3 for Greaves, 3 for Metalworker at 4 floating, then tap Metalworker for another 2, 4, 6. Yeah, and then I have 11, then I play Lodestone Golem Karn. I'm doing all this in theory after Mindbreak Trapping my opponent out, but hey, I mean, it was a 2-minute match, so that's what you get.